Keep hearing that whole it's longer than wait time, supervisor, gotta put you on hold again, sorry for the wait time. It's like a lot of people calling and complaining, and take the time to write a message. Took me half an hour or so. Not the fastest typer in the world. Just to find out that their email thing is form is down, and to email them directly, which I don't do Gmail or whatever other option there is on these smartphones these days on Android. And then they send me an email saying that they're going to try to get back to me within 24 hours, blah, blah, blah. I'm calling to make sure that they actually are going to read the letter that I wrote without me having to go all over through all the details again. In today's age, literally every other day, week, month, you got to call somebody to double check on some, or call them to say, hey, what's going on? I got overcharged, and it's ridiculous. And I have a feeling that it's not just me, and it's not just a few people falling through the cracks. I have a feeling it's a lot more people. And these companies keep getting away with it, and I think that's why they keep doing it. And if we had people that knew how to fight up, stand up, and were willing to take the time, I think they'd stop doing it. I think they really would be on accident instead of part of their system. My girlfriend looks at me crazy. My ex-girlfriend used to look at me crazy. My best friend thinks, well, he knows I'm crazy, but he thinks that I give these people a hard time and it's not their fault and whatnot and stuff. And yeah, I do feel sorry for them that they have to pick up the phone and deal with someone like me. But I'm just not going to be able to let people take advantage of me. That's, they're not going to sell me something and not come through with the deal. Take all my money, but not give me whole deal. So I'm just that kind of person, has to stand up for rights. And when people, unfortunately, whether they're ignorant or they're just following the textbook rules, they want to make sure it's, they want to give me the BS business. Well, I'm not going to take that either. I'm going to have to put them in their place. I speak very clear English. I have usually, I have all the information and facts and a good memory and chronological order of how things happen, and I'm able to explain to them what's going on. Now, if they're not up to par with being able to deal with someone like me, or they're not able to keep up with an intelligent person, give them the info, the lowdown on how to progress forward to help the situation. Not my fault. I just got a feeling that somehow I'm going to have to get transferred to somebody else. That all this wait here is going to be for nothing. I don't know. But I called the number on the email, so. Why don't they have interesting facts on these things? Like a company could like record like a Discovery Channel thing or something, a Shark Week or something, where you could listen to something and actually learn. You could have Neil deGrasse Tyson on here talking about physics and stuff like that. It's outer space. So unfortunately, folks, before I used to just try to make things fair or get a little bit of compensation, a little $10 and stuff. Now I'm like up to the point where I want a free month of something, or I double things, or 50%. I mean, I'm just at that point right now where this just keeps happening. So unfortunately, I was with Travel Velocity on a vacation plan for a good deal to Hawaii for 5 days. Cost me like $836. That's flight, hotel, and I got like a little tour with Continental Breakfast or something like that. That's how they try to get your money and stuff like that. But I was just gonna see the island and not buy anything and get a little free breakfast or something, or maybe get free breakfast and then be out. But They ended up taking 45 minutes when I got there, and I was hungry too. It was like noon when I got there. It's a little difference in time here from California, so.
Thank you for calling. We recognize
I was hungry, and I just decided to just take my stuff. Walk a quarter mile, half mile down the road to get something to eat. Came back, and they gave me this room. It was 4th of July weekend. I think I came the day before 4th of July, or 2 days before 4th of July, or something. Yeah, like two or three days before 4th of July. And they gave me a 2 twin-size room, and I'm going, hold on, I'm supposed to get a queen size or something like that. And then, oh, well, that's not our fault, this and that. So they had problems with the reservations in the first place, even though it's supposed to be confirmed. And then went back and forth, wasted a bunch of time. Wanted to talk to a manager from Travelocity. He ends up calling me at like 6 o'clock in the morning, almost woke me up. I actually woke up for some weird reason about 10 minutes before that. But he calls me on my vacation to try to help me fix this issue and get compensation while I'm on vacation. And he didn't want to play ball with me at all. I was extremely upset. So all in all, I think I only got reimbursed for them not picking me up. That's what happened with the little tour thing. I was out there for an hour. So no compensation for my time or anything like that, just straight up. Oh, well, I guess we got records, we didn't actually pick them up. So they gave me like $36 or something like that for that, $30 or something like that. But they waste an hour of my time. I didn't get breakfast that I was supposed to get. And then I didn't get the room. And they tried to say that the two bed thing was an upgrade as opposed to one, but I'm single all by myself. How's that an upgrade? I'm sleeping in a smaller bed. Not to mention they had a generator. That's probably why it was like one of the last rooms they had, I'm guessing. It's because it's the most annoying. This generator going off 24/7. It must have been like the air conditioning generator for 10 floors or something like that, or whatever it was. And it was on my balcony. And then the view was, instead of an ocean side, it was a Terrence view, so all I could see is a bunch of buildings and people going down the street in their cars and motorcycles and whatnot, instead of being able to see palm trees and an ocean. So the next day I actually had to switch rooms, which takes more time, but I got the room I was supposed to, and oh, it was beautiful. It was just like I should have gotten when I first got there, and all that stress and everything wouldn't have happened and everything like that, but I won't be traveling with Travel Velocity unless I'm desperate. Now today they got all these sites together, so all these companies that disrespect you and take advantage of you and everything like that, they just go and say, oh, it's Kayak or whatever, blah, it's this and that, and then they get your money anyways. They like the diverse. Life really is a yin and yang. Hi, my name's Anthony. Did you say your name is Chris?
Yes.
All right, Chris. So I've been on hold for about almost 18 minutes now. Not your fault. I did hear the automated telephone line say that you give people a very personal and complete experience, conversation with them. Uh-huh. So I am looking forward to that.